Hi buddy, welcome to Kaggle Titanic Machine Learning from Disaster Chapter 1. In this video, we will define the problem statement, collect data, and explore data analysis. So, step 1, defining the problem statement. If you go to the https://www.kaggle.com/c/titanic, you will see the competition description here. In short, the problem is the complete analysis of what sorts of people were likely to survive. In particular, we ask you to apply the tools of machine learning to predict which passengers survived the tragedy. So this is the problem. So we define the problem here. Now how we can collect the data? Well, the train dataset and the test dataset are given by Kaggle. You can download from my GitHub this URL. If you go to my GitHub URL, you can clone my GitHub URL kaggle-titanic. This one has already my Python notebook, has the solution. Also, if you go to the input, it already has the test dataset and the train dataset. Or you can go to the Kaggle website itself here, go to the Kaggle, and you can download the data, test CSV and train CSV here, and click the download button. You can do either way here to collect the data. Step 3, exploratory data analysis here. So we can load, train, and test dataset using pandas. I'm a big fan of pandas. You can use other tool if you can find, but I'm using pandas in this video. So I import pandas here, and train is my data frame for the train dataset, and the test here is my data frame for the test dataset. I can easily visualize this train or test dataset using pandas. I will show you later. So, if you want to see how the train set looks like, you can just say head train.head here. So, this is one of the function of the pandas for the data frame. So, I use the head function for the train dataset. This will give you just 5 rows in this training dataset. As you can see here, we have the 12 features here. Mostly, it's obvious to understand, like the passenger ID or name, sex, but you may need this data dictionary I provided here. So survived 0 means this person is dead, and the survival 1 means this person is survived. And what is the P class? P class means ticket class, like the first one, the number one means the first class, like the airplane first class. So if you see the fare of the first class, this price is much higher than the class 3. So 1 means first class, 3 means like the third class or like economic class. Okay, and what is SIB, SP? I think this is not English word, this is short term of the English word like sibling and spouse. So if you upload the Titanic with your sibling or spouse, this number will not be 0. 0 means you don't have a sibling, you don't have a spouse. And parche is not an English word. Also, this means the parents or the children you upload with in the Titanic. So this 0 means you don't have the parents or children aboard with the Titanic. So if the CSIB, SP0, PAR, CH0, this means you just aboard in the Titanic alone. Okay, and you can see NAN in the cabin. NAN means not a number. You can think this is the field, missing field in this data. You will need to fill out this using the feature engineering or just delete the entire row. I'm going to go over this feature engineering technology in the next video. And embarked, it just stands for the port of the embarkation. And this character is just the first character of the port. Okay, so if you see test.head here, then you will see this one has only 11 features. Only missing field from the training data set is the survived field. This is obvious because we are going to predict if the passenger survived or not using this data set. This is because this one doesn't have the survived field. And if you see the train.shape here, this is the one of the pandas function. This will give you how many rows and columns in the train data set. So you can see this train data has 891 the passengers with 12 features. So if you say test.shape here, then it has 418 passengers here and 11 features. As I said before, it has one last feature because it doesn't have the survived field. We are going to predict the survived using other features here. And if you say train.info here, this is very useful. Info is very useful because you will see this. We already saw that there are 891 rows here, but you can see the age is 714 and the cabin is 204. So there are some missing fields in the age and the cabin here. Also, if you see the test.info here, you can see age and age is 332 and the cabin is 91 out of the 418 passengers. So there are some missing cabin and the AG. We will need to fill out these things using the feature engineering. I'm going to go over this in the next video thoroughly. So there is another function that we can use very usefully is isNull.sum. So if you use a train that is null.sum, then it will give the whole null count. So as you can see, obviously the age has 177 because we already saw the missing field in the age and the cabin. This is showing that this non-NAM field was the null value. We are going to fill this in the next video. Also test in the test is null.sum, it shows the sum null value in the age and cabin. We will need some feature engineering on this missing field. So now this is the most fun part. We are going to visualize some bar chart here. I'm going to see the relationship between the survived with other features here. So I'm going to use the Seaborn. Seaborn is very beautiful chart. I'm going to use Seaborn in this video for the categorical features here. Here we have the categorical features: P-class, sex, SIBSP, perch, embarked, and the cabin. So here I created one function bar chart. This is nothing but just get one feature as parameter and going to give two bar charts. One is the survived, the other one is the dead. So we are going to see the relationship between the survived with the feature I give. So I'm going to click Shift Enter to run this function and going to just reuse this function for each field. So first, let's take a look at the sex here. So here the blue color is the female. As you can see, the blue color female survived, more likely survived than the dead. And the green color here is male. You can see that the male, most male are dead. And very less male are survived here. So from this chart, we can confirm that the women more likely survived than men. And the next one is the pickless. I'm going to run this bar chart, Shift Enter. Here, as you can see, the number one is the first class, well, which is very rich guys. They survived more than the dead, right? But the people in the economic class, like number three classes here, the red color here, less people survived, many people are died here. And how about the SIBSP? So siblings and the spouse, if the person has a spouse or the sibling in the Titanic together, well, if they were alone, looks like more likely dead. But if you see this chart, then here's yellow and something, the other colors, but there is no color. So looks like if you have siblings or spouse, looks like the captain or the people over there gave more opportunity to be survived if they have some family in the Titanic. And I can see very similar result for the parents and children as well. We will see more specifically in the next video with feature engineering. But this gives some the rough information from this bar chart as well. And embarked. I don't know if the embarked is very important for the dead or survived here, but we can get some information that the blue color S, if we embarked from the S port, then more likely dead, right? And if you embarked from the port Q, then they also more likely dead. I don't know if this green color is more like similar, right? Similar each other. But I don't know. This bar chart doesn't give many information. We probably need more the feature engineering in the next video for this one. Okay, so this is pretty much of this video. Before finishing, I should say thanks to this reference I referred to create this video. I appreciate sharing brilliant ideas, and I hope my video also helps to us. I covered problem definition, collect data, data exploration in this video, and in the following next video, I will continue from feature engineering and the modeling and the testing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.